a school tried to downplay a white student choking a black student, tried to basically say, oh, they were just horseplaying. Yeah, nothing to see here. And then we get a video that shows the black student went unconscious, passed out. It was much more than the school said it was. Video evidence has exposed it. Let's put the picture full mass. Okay. Video evidence, that's a screenshot, has revealed an incident at a Kentucky middle school, initially downplayed as horseplay. Is something so much more disturbing than that. Casey County Middle School is the site of the potential hate crime after a white student, you see him there, strangled and assaulted a black student, you see him there as well, in the school's bathroom. Video of the incident captures racial slurs being used as the attacker places the child in a chokehold until he loses consciousness. Now, I want to remind you, the school said, oh, there's nothing here. It was just kids horseplaying, okay? Now, there's another reason why they do this. Because of federal dollars that go into school systems now, and the media hasn't reported on this aspect yet. They will eventually. Because of that federal money that goes into school systems, the school has to show decreased numbers of bullying incidents. When they categorize it as horseplay, it does not work against them for their federal anti-bullying dollars. Okay? That's a federal issue now. There's more. Let's put the picture back up again. It's horrific, I know. But the school tried to cover this up. That's what they tried to cover up. The 6-second video also recorded other students laughing at the black student, telling him, tap out, man. After the footage went viral, the aggressive juvenile, the one choking, the one doing the choking, has been charged with 4th-degree assault and felony strangulation. Now, remember, the school initially said, nothing to watch here. There's nothing but horseplay. Okay? So on Monday, April 25th, Liberty Police Chief Stephen Garrett stated, detectives are looking for more videos outside of the one shared on social media of the assault, which happened on Friday, April 22nd. He also noted that the young person's case will not be handled in an adult court, but under the jurisdiction of the juvenile court system and will not be a public record. That's typical for juvenile proceedings. The school immediately responded to the video, issuing a Facebook statement the day after April 22nd, and it said, we are aware of a video that started circulating on social media last night involving an incident between some students at Casey County Middle School. The school administrators took immediate action with the support from a Liberty Police Department deputy who serves as the school resource officer. Now, here's the thing. They took immediate action after the video went viral. They did not take immediate action when the incident occurred. They said it was horse play, okay? That child could have died and your institution protected the one who committed the assault, okay? Let's put up the picture of the superintendent. Barry D. Lee is the superintendent of Casey County Schools. He issued a similar statement condemning the incident and reiterating immediate action was taken, but stressing the district must be proactive in helping our students to understand that this is not acceptable behavior. Once again, Mr. Superintendent, lies. Immediate action was taken when you had no choice but to take action when the video went viral. There's more. Let's put up the resource officer. Jordan Buis, that's the resource officer. He suggested the campus administration did not know the severity of the altercation until the video surfaced online. We were unaware here. I mean, what do you expect us to do to be school administrators? He said they were unaware. They just didn't know. Don't blame us. He added further, we're not going to stand for anything like that. If anything needs criminal charges, they're going to have them. Let's put up a picture of the victim's sister, okay? She was willing to be bold about her proclamation against racism. Good for her. Dontatia Sutherland, strong young lady. She too had her own encounters with racism within the same county school system, Casey County, saying that she was disgusted by the incident with her little brother, but added it did not start and stop with him because she too has faced racism in that same school. So here it is. You have an issue of culture, not just an issue of policy. And I believe the black students here, because all of the evidence points to your cover up, your attempted cover up, and your lack of protection allocated to the young person who was choked. All right, David, thoughts here?
Also a lack of curiosity. I mean, for the school resource officer to say, I was not aware until the video came out. I mean, look, there was a student who was unconscious. You were aware that there was a student unconscious. That should have provoked an immediate investigation. And the fact of the matter is, I hate it when a school superintendent issues, well, we were not aware, or we are aware that there's a video. No, you've seen the video, and you don't need to say, I'm aware of the video. You can say, I've seen the video, it's wrong, and there will be consequences. These sort of soft vanilla statements about, oh, we're sort of investigating, we're sort of aware what happened, that just delegitimizes the real problem that we have here, and this problem is significant.
Very well said, David.